Geeks, what's up? We're here with the Stepford Cuckoos. Gonna get one of them out of the box. Gonna leave the rest caged up. See what she's talking about. Let's go. Okay, so the reason that I have four of the Stepford Cuckoos is because I'm trying to do a set of five. If you don't read the books, the original Stepford Cuckoos, there was five of them, and two of them died later on in battle. So I want to get all five and then customize two of the heads. And when I say customize, I just mean paint their hair, just to differentiate them so I can have a set of five. Here she is in the package. See, she's got her standard Xavier School for the Gifted plaid private school outfit. Looks pretty good. Then you've got the two different heads. You've got the red head and you've got the black head, and you've got, it comes with the blonde. Also down here, you see you've got an extra set of hands. You got a fist for each side, and you have Cerebro. Psychically linked mutants, the Cuckoo Sisters are powerful clones of the telepath Emma Frost. What? On the side of the box, you see you got a picture of all three Cuckoos. All right, here's a look at Cuckoo, still in her cage. Oh, nifty. And all the promo shots I saw, I don't know if I'm not remembering or just didn't see them, they have power effects on the arms. Cool. Okay, so we've got the red head sculpt with long hair. We've got the black bob cut. Then, of course, you've got the blonde head that comes on it in the box. That's good. Shang-Chi, what are you doing here? Look, man, I know we got some beef and some things we gotta talk about, but I told you not to just show up unannounced. I'm in the middle of reviewing the Stepford Cuckoos. You and I will talk later. I'm serious, dude. Don't do anything crazy. No, Shang-Chi, why? Why? They were just innocent girls and you beheaded them. Just because of what I said, look, we'll talk later, dude. Chill, let me just finish this review. All right, so I'm digging this uniform. A lot of detail in it. I'm a fan of schoolgirl uniforms. I don't mean that in a perverted way, but it's like when I see them in anime and I see them in real life, I just think they're really nice. And this is well done. The plaid stripes are straight. They don't have any blur. They've got pleats in the skirt. She's got the little tie there. I like these clear effects. Unlike the effects that come with a lot of figures, they actually fit. They're nice and tight on the arm. Turn around from the back. The jacket is nice and shiny. Falls at the waist, has a split in the tail. Looks good. Socks are, I don't want to say thigh high or calf high, but the paint job is really good. She's got a little bit of a crooked foot like Polaris did, but hers adjusts. My Polaris does not. I wish I had realized it in time and returned it. Yeah, so overall, pretty good looking so far. All right, so even with the ponytail and the jacket, you do get a 360 rotation on the head. There we go. This is the head looking straight forward. The head really does not lean back. Could be because of the ponytail, but I tried to move and it wouldn't move. This is looking down. It moves further down than it does back, but you don't get a lot of leeway there. It still looks almost the same as when she's looking straight ahead. So not a lot of flexibility in the head. So I'm gonna put it right straight. Straight back up now, and you see it's not really that different. Very slight angle downwards. All right, so I was very wary of bending her arm because I don't know if you guys follow me on Instagram, but I posted on Instagram a while back that one of my Danny Moonstars, I tried to bend her arm and it snapped right off. So I was scared to do this, but you do get a decent bend here. It looks like a straight 90 degree angle. Doesn't really come up much further, so she can't touch her chest or chin area or anything like that. She does do a decent split, and there are actually slits and separations in the skirt so she can do the split. That's pretty cool. It lifts up right there and also right there. So that is kind of awesome. The legs are great. I don't know if these are new joints, but these look like, I don't know. They have the double joint, but something looks different about them. But great flexibility going forward and going back. You can see that the toe points straight up. She can kick her butt. For contrast on the feet, pointing up and pointing straight down. You do get a 360 degree swivel at the torso, but not at the waist. So when it spins right here, right below the breast. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah, you can see the line there now. Very slight bend of the torso. I don't even know if you can tell the difference right now. I'm gonna straighten it up while you're watching. I don't know if you can see the difference, but it's a very slight bend. It almost doesn't make a difference. Let me show you in real time. That's a very slight bend. Nothing to write home about. Her arms do go up shoulder height. Not much higher. Actually, not higher at all. So you can get some decent poses out of there, but if you want to put her hand above her head, you have to swivel the arm upside down. You do get a full 360 degree thigh swivel. And again, I'm really impressed with the legs here. Somebody correct me if I'm wrong. This joint does look new, but then again, you know, I have a lot of figures I haven't opened. I always put that out there. I'm still a new collector. I haven't been collecting for a year yet. But of all the figures I've opened, I don't remember a knee joint like this. So I'm very impressed with the flexibility with the lower half of the body. It'll be good for posing. The top, not so much. I don't see her serial mark. That's weird. They've been putting them on the thigh, but they didn't put, it's in like a light gray, so you can barely see it. Man, much better. Thank you, Hasbro, for not stamping black ink on the middle of the thigh to make an eyesore. That's awesome. Now with Cerebro. And I think this is the only head that Cerebro will fit on properly, with quotation marks. I don't think it fits that well on this head either, but it didn't fit on the blonde head with the ponytail. And the redhead has a ponytail as well. And the red hair. All right, geeks, so let me know what you think. I've got to say, thumbs up on the figure. Even though the flexibility on the upper half of the body is lacking, it makes up for it in the flexibility on the bottom half and the styling, the sculpting, the painting. I mean, it's just an awesome figure in my opinion. And again, I say in my opinion because everybody has a different opinion. But the uniform's on point, the face sculpt's on point, the hair's on point, the colors pop off it. And I mean, I just think it's a great figure. Even if you're not a fan of Stepford Cuckoos, it's something awesome to have in your collection. So let me know what you think. Are you hunting them down? Are you just getting one? Are you getting a complete set? Until next time, geek out.